So, you don't have time for philosophy? Well, we'll try and fix that with a new slimmed down series of short videos called The Philosophists Shorts. Today we are talking to Professor James Tartaglia, Professor of Metaphysical Philosophy at Keele University. James is the author of Inner Space Philosophy, Why the Next Stage of Human Development Should Be Philosophical, Explained Radically and Suitable for Wolves. And today I ask James why he thinks presentation and imagination are so important to his conception of philosophy. And of course, what about those wolves?
Well, I start with the wolves in that I just don't believe, I sort of take seriously the kind of conversations the Greeks had about writing. You know, people like Plato had very serious reservations about writing, despite the fact that, you know, he lent us all this literature, which is going to be, you know, so important for the Western world. I mean, people still don't actually understand the circumstances in which those books were published. Presumably they were mainly for his students, but they survived. But he did worry about it because you'll see some of the discussions of this in the beginning of the book, because he thought, you know, people might get the wrong impression. And, you know, Socrates definitely thought of philosophy as something where you tailor what you say to the individual person. It's a dialogue, very much, you know. And Plato wrote these dialogues, kind of idealized dialogues for his students. But what that kind of got me thinking was, well, a couple of things. First of all, I thought to myself, well, you know, you can't tell people what to think. I mean, philosophy is about independent thought. You know, there's a great quote I like from Montaigne, where he says, you know, if you teach a student Plato's views, you know, that they learn Plato's views, but they won't be their views. Whereas if they read it and they think it themselves, then it ceases to be Plato's view. It becomes their view. Okay. And that's what it's like with reading a book. I mean, like people don't trust you. People will like be looking to disagree. People have made up their mind before they start, you know. And I thought, well, you know, if it's a philosophy book, right, all you really can ever hope to do is to suggest some things, to try and provoke people to get thinking. You can suggest what you think, but you can't, you know, you can't play follow my leader, right? This is what I think. And it kind of reminded me of a bit like how a wolf hunts, right? Okay, they leap all over the place and do a bit of playing and jump over each other and go off in different sections. But they're all kind of following the leader, you know. At the end of the day, the author is kind of the leader, but, you know, the pack goes their own way. The pack goes their own way. It also reminded me of a great metaphor I once read on an album review. God, I don't know where this was from, but they were talking about Miles Davis's second great quintet, where the theme ceases to follow the straightforward format of jazz, where you play the theme, then everybody solos, then you play the theme. And the guy said, just something that stuck in my head, he said the musicians start to stalk the theme like a wolf pack. They come to it and they sort of attack it, and bring, sort of stuck in my head, so I thought of that as well.